This is a personal opinion, not in my capacity as a senator of South Australia, is that every time you come to a dispute, you need to engage dispute, whatever nature, political, domestic, family, contract. Once you come to an area where two people are in dispute, they need to look at the dispute as a dispute. I believe political disputes are solved politically. I also believe the best solution is homegrown. Kenyans will need to homegrow their own solution. AU, Australia, all those other people can talk, but only Kenyans know their problem. This issue of tribalism is such an entrenched Kenyan problem, and only Kenyans can resolve to further their nation. So what I think and what I know in my little experience is any community, whether it is church, whether it is family, is normally divided 50-50. One side bakes the cake, the other side eats the cake. And it's one side which is the bakers of the cake, you protect their baking process. The eaters you protect. This is political common sense, and it will be there forever. However, people need to understand what is democracy. If I'm in democracy and my counterpart gets 50.001%, it is a democracy, and the rule says I accept that outcome. So we all have this education kind of things, but it has to be homegrown. The two leaders have been leaders, political leaders, for time immemorial, since I've ever started hearing these two names. So people come together, face the challenge before them, solve it politically. But I think as Kenyans need to give their leaders time to lead. Otherwise, they are going to be in this mode of negotiation forever. It doesn't matter. The world outside are still watching. They are just spectators. It is the Kenyan, the ordinary day Kenyan, who pays the price. So I think it is time that Kenyans moved on with their life, and the leaders got in to engage and lead and engage in their politics as politicians.
My views first, of course, you know, talking will take place. But as you talk, you must also acknowledge and accept that there's a president who has been sworn in, a president who was elected and sworn in, and we discuss from that level. You cannot say you don't recognize somebody and you want to talk. So I think you first of all appreciate and recognize that there's a president who has been elected, he's in office, and you talk to him as a president of the Republic of Kenya, and not talk about many other things that will be there. So that is, I think, the starting point, and I'm sure there will be more discussions and talks that will